Hello students, welcome to our today lecture. In our today lecture we are going to apply the Johansson co-integration test. Basically Johansson co-integration test is applied to check that either there exists a long run relationship between the variables or not. So for that purpose Johansson co-integration test has been applied. But the condition for applying of Johansson co-integration test is that your variables must be stationary at first difference. If your variable are not stationary at first difference, then you cannot apply Johansson co-integration test. So before applying Johansson co-integration test, make sure that your variables are stationary at first difference. So then comes next, why we are applying Johansson co-integration test. So Johansson co-integration test applied to check the long run relationship between the variables. If there is co-integration between the variables, then we can apply VECM or the vector error correction model. But if there is no co-integration, then we can apply only unrestricted VAR model. So in case of no co-integration, we are unable to apply VECM model. So basically Johansson co-integration test guide us that which of these tests has to be applied. If co-integration exists, then we apply VECM, and if co-integration does not exist, then we can apply only unrestricted VAR model. So basically this is the major requirement for checking long run existence between the variable, and for that purpose we use Johansson co-integration test. So now let's go back to stata file. So before applying Johansson co-integration test, we have to bring all of our data set into stata file. So we have to simply copy all of our data set, then go to stata, then go to data editor option, then paste your all of data set here. Here it is asking that do you want to treat the first row as variable names or data. It means that if you go with this option, it will give you your variable names in the top first row. So it would be easier for us to understand our data set. So we are going to adopt this option, treat first row as variable name. So here you can see that when we selected the particular option, it treated first row as our variable name. Then go to stata file again, then go to statistics, then go to multivariate time series. Then here you can see there is an option of co-integrated rank of VECM. Then click on this option. Then here you have to type all of your variable name, GOV, POPD, GDP, GFDI. Here it is asking about how much lag you are going to interested in your model. So I am going with this default option that we are going to include only 2 lags in our model. So then it is asking about either you are interested to include constant term in your model, either you are interested in to include trend in your model. So again we are going with the default option of including constant in our model. Then go to reporting, then also select report maximum eigenvalues. Okay, then go to time setting, then select year, as my data set is in year form, and from here you have to tell about what is the nature of your data set, either your data is monthly, weekly, yearly. As my data set is in yearly form, so I am going with this option. Then click on OK, and then here also click on OK. So here it have given you the results of Johansson test for co-integration. Number of observation 27, lags included in the model are 2. So now what is the guideline? The guideline is that we have to see, or we have to compare this trace statistic value with this critical value of 5%. And what is the null and alternative hypothesis? So here it is the null hypothesis. 0 mean that there is no co-integration equation. 1 mean that there is one co-integration equation. 2 mean that there are two co-integrated equation. 3 means that there is three co-integrated equation in our model. 4 means that there are 4 co-integrated equation in our model. All of these are H naught. So basically there are 5 alternative null hypothesis in our model and 5 alternative hypothesis in our model. So all of these are null hypothesis. 0 mean there is no co-integrated equation in our model. So I am going to write here so that what is H naught 0 mean. So there is no co-integrated equation. And what does H1 or alternative other hypothesis mean? That there is co-integrated equation. So this is for 0. So the 0 here, 0 is saying its null hypothesis means that there is no co-integrated equation, and its alternative hypothesis is that there is co-integrated equation in our model. Or it also means that there exists a long run relationship between our models. So we have to compare this trace statistic value with this value. If the trace statistic value is less than the critical value, then we have to accept the H naught. So I will also write here, if the trace stat value is lower than critical value of 5%, then accept H naught. So if the trace statistic value is lower than the critical value of 5%, then accept H naught. But if trace statistics is higher than the critical value, then you have to reject the null hypothesis or H naught. As in our case, our trace statistics value is higher than the critical value of 5%. So it means we have to reject the null hypothesis. What is our null hypothesis? Null hypothesis means that there is no co-integrated equation. We have to reject this option and we have to accept this. It means that there is co-integrated equation. So we can apply Johansson, we can apply VECM model, as there exists a long run relationship between these variables. So whenever there exists a long run relationship between our variables, so in that case we can apply VECM model. So now let's see what does max statistic values tell us. Again, we have to compare max statistics value, the critical value of 5%. Similarly, in this case, our max statistic value is higher than the critical value of 5%, meaning that we have to reject the null hypothesis. And what was null hypothesis? Null hypothesis was that there is no co-integrated equation. So we have to reject the null hypothesis and we have to accept the alternative hypothesis. So both of these two tests tell us that there exists a long run relationship between the variables. So we can apply VECM model or vector error correction model. So this is how you can apply Johansson quantigration test, and there is one another option for applying Johansson quantigration test, and that is option is command option. So the command for applying Johansson quantigration test is VEC rank, and then you have to write all of your variable name GOV, POPD, GDP, GFDI. So then press enter, and this will give you the results for Johansson cointegration test. So this is the second method, or by using command method for applying Johansson cointegration test. And if you want to increase or decrease the number of lag size, so then write all the command here, and here you can write how much lags you are going to include in your model. So here I am interested in to take 4 lags. So I have to type simply lags, and then I have to write here lags 4, and okay. So here you can see that now it have taken 4 lags in our model. So this is how you can apply Johansson quantigration test of for checking the long run relationship between the variables.